Hello, beloved. I welcome you once again to the Way of Salvation program. And I believe that you are loving the messages and they are helping you to understand the operations of demons. In the last episode, I handled the question as to whether it is good to talk about demons in the church. And from the way it went, I believe you have understood it now. So that question is answered. Today I want us to look at the role of demons concerning pastoral duties. If you saw in the last episode, I was going to talk about the role of a pastor in casting out demons. So today I want us to look at demonic oppression and pastoral duties. Demonic oppression and pastoral duties. I told you in the last episode that the Lord calls us and commissions us to go and preach about the kingdom. And in the summary, I said, when they believe the gospel and come into the church, then it becomes the responsibility of the pastor, the leader, the fivefold minister, to cast out the demons from such people so that they can experience heaven on earth in their lives. That is how it went. So today, agree with me as we turn our Bibles to John chapter 10, verse 1 to 3. The Lord Jesus was speaking here. He said, most assuredly, I say to you, he who does not enter the sheepfold by the door, but climbs up some other way, the same is a thief and a robber. Verse 2 says, but he who enters by the door is the shepherd of the sheep. To him the doorkeeper opens, and the sheep hears his voice, and he calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. Amen. So that is what I want us to look at. Why I want us to look at this scripture, to connect it with what I'm dealing with today, is that the Lord Jesus is the master shepherd. He is the overall shepherd. I am an under shepherd. So if I want to talk about the shepherd, the role of a shepherd, Jesus is the perfect example. And in this scripture, the Lord said, in verse 3, he said, he enters by the door, and the doorkeeper opens. He came through the door. Jesus, as the good shepherd, came through the door. That means he was given access to the sheep by the doorkeeper. Now, the doorkeeper here is the Most High God, Almighty God, the Creator. He is the doorkeeper. So the one who enters is the shepherd. So Jesus was talking as the man here. So the doorkeeper is God, who gives the shepherd, who gave the Lord Jesus as the shepherd the access to the sheep. And he went through the door. He was called and sanctioned by the Almighty God. That is why the Lord God Almighty said, this is my beloved son. Hear him. Everyone should hear him. because in him I am well pleased. So Jesus was given access to the universal sheep, universal church, universal children of God by God himself. Amen. The second point is that he said, I am the door. If you see it, he was talking about the door. So when you talk about the doorkeeper opening the door, the Lord Jesus was saying he is the door. So no one can get access to the sheep without getting to deal with him first. So to get to the sheep, you need to remove Jesus. You need to get past Jesus. Hallelujah. He is standing as the door. And God is the doorkeeper. So to get access to the sheep, you need to get and deal with Jesus as the shepherd. Point three. Verse 11, he said, I am the good shepherd. I am the good shepherd. Then he says, the good shepherd gives his life for the sheep. The good shepherd gives his life for the sheep. In other words, the good shepherd sacrifices for the sheep. You stand in front of them, so you make sacrifices. In other words, you prevent any danger from coming to the sheep. That is what the Lord said. So he said he did that. When he said he's the door, verse 10 said, I do that as the door, because if I don't do that and prevent the thief from coming inside and harm the sheep, he will come in and to steal, to kill, and to destroy. The thief is coming to the sheep, into the sheep, to kill, to steal, and to destroy. And Jesus said, I am the good shepherd, and I lay my life. I sacrifice my life on behalf of the sheep. That is what the Lord was doing as a good shepherd. Now, when I'm talking about the role of a pastor and demonic oppression, the best thing to look at is the Lord's example. We need to emulate his example and then follow suit. As a good shepherd, you also do the same thing. So the thing I'm talking about is that if you say you are called by God, then look at these three things I'm still talking about. The first thing is you should pass through the door. As the Lord said, any man of God who is called by him should pass through the door. That means you should have a calling. Not all of them are called. Not everyone who says he is a pastor is called by God. Let me sum up in three ways, then you can understand. Some are called by God. Others are put there by demons. I told you the other day that demons have their so-called pastors and prophets. The third group, I'll deal with it shortly. The third group. So, if you say you are called by God, pass through the door. Passing through the door means God Almighty will call you and give you access and give you oversight over his church. So, understand that one. Called by God. Number two, you are the door. The Lord said, I am the door. So, when you go through the door, you are not coming in and be with the sheep. You are the door. You are actually the door. So if there's any harm coming to the sheep, you as the shepherd, you stand there as the door. And if the danger is coming, you are the one standing there to block it. If someone, if an enemy wants to harm the sheep, then he has to deal with you first. You lay down your life for the sheep, just as the Lord Jesus came to do. He is the overall shepherd. We as under shepherds should follow his example. You are like the night security. The door should be locked when people are going to sleep. Because of evil people, we lock the doors. Now, you, the pastor, you are the door. The door should be a strong iron door. It should be a strong iron security door. Making it highly impossible for thieves to break in. Ask yourself whether you are a good dog. Now you are also the night security. In other parlance, they say watchman. You watch over the people. You are the night security. That is how it should be. So let us look at Hebrews chapter 13, verse 17. Verse 17 says, the book of Hebrews 13, 17. Obey those who rule over you and be submissive. It's talking to church people. He said, then this one comes in, the responsibility. Then he says, for they watch out for yourselves as those who must give account. So I hope you understand this one. So he was talking to church people that they should be submissive and obey the shepherd. And the responsibility is what I am talking about. You watch over their souls while they are asleep, even as they are alive. You see? So you watch over their soul. So you are the shepherd who watches over the souls of the sheep. Amen. That is how it should be. So when you are a shepherd, let me give you a very unique way a normal shepherd does. You know, normally, sometimes the sheep is attacked. Some pest attacks the sheep. And you are the shepherd. A very good shepherd rubs oil on the bodies of the animals to prevent any parasites from attacking them. So that is what normally the shepherd does. So you do that and you prevent any attacks from coming to them. That is exactly what the pastor also does. You also prevent the enemy. I've told you that we have God. That Lucifer led the angels to rebel and they fell. When they fell, he's building his own kingdom. So we have two kingdoms. We have the kingdom of God and the kingdom of Lucifer. We have demons and we have angels. These are spirits. You don't see them. But we as human beings too, we have people who have demons in them, living to glorify demons. On the other hand, we also have people who have the Holy Spirit in them, living to glorify the Almighty God. And you as the pastor, you as the shepherd, entrusted the oversight, entrusted the leadership. You have to see to it that some enemies, the wolves, will not come and attack the sheep. You prevent that. You are the representative of God over the sheep. You should prevent any attack. That is what David was doing. When David was a young boy who was entrusted the sheep of his father Jesse, he prevented the lion and the bear from attacking the sheep. He fought and opened up the mouth of a lion to let the sheep go free. That is exactly what you as a pastor, you need to do. You need to stand in as the gap. You need to stand in as the wall. You need to stand in as someone fighting for the innocent sheep. That is what God calls people to do for him. That is what Jesus came to do. So if you represent Jesus, then take care of his sheep. That is why the Lord told Peter, Simon Peter, if you love me, then tend to my sheep. Take care of my sheep. So pastor, if you love Jesus, take care of the sheep. Take care of the church to prevent the thief from stealing from them spiritually. To prevent the thief from destroying them. To prevent the thief from killing them. That is your role as a shepherd. You prevent and protect. You prevent the demons and protect the church. That was exactly what David did. He protected the innocent sheep. They are innocent. You have to prevent them. If demons are killing people in the church, then you need to wake up. Then something is wrong. If demons are stealing from the church, you know the Bible says when a thief is caught, he should restore seven times. So when I get a demon, I always force them to restore whatever they have stolen from the church. You have to bring back. It is very funny when some pastors even don't want to talk about demon, let alone when they think they touch someone and the person falls down, so the demon left. You are very funny. That is very childish. If someone falls down, it doesn't mean a demon is left. That is nothing. You have to deal with the demon and let him bring whatever he stole from the sheep. So I always force them to restore. What do they steal? They steal normally your glory. They don't like the glory to be with you at all. And when they have your glory, your success, your life, your finances, everything is in the glory. They steal these things and I let them restore them. So pastor, prevent the demons from stealing from the sheep. Prevent them from destroying them. If they are destroying your church people, then it's very sad. And lastly, prevent the demons from killing the sheep. These are the three things. The Lord said to destroy, to steal, to destroy, and the last one, to kill. That's why I told you the other time, if pastors are letting demons kill church people and you attend funerals every week, if there's a funeral ceremony every week, funeral rites for people every week and you go, demons are winning. It shouldn't be so at all. I hope you have learned something as a pastor. Do your best and understand why the Lord called you. If you do so, you are demonstrating your love for the Lord, as the Lord told Simon Peter. May God give you understanding in Jesus' name. I don't want you to go to hell, but I want you to live a demon-free life that will be the holy life that will send you to heaven. May God bless you. I will see you again. Bless you. Bye-bye.
Thank you for watching this video. I really hope you have been enlightened. To hear more, you may subscribe to this channel and click the notification bell to see more videos. Pastor Kukudatsi has written a very informative book called How Demons Operate. Grab yourself a copy to know how they operate and know how to liberate yourself from demonic oppression. To stay in contact with us, you can reach us through these details. God bless you.